Welcome to my YouTube channel No Biology. I am here to simplify all the important biology concept which is important for class 11, 12 and as well as NEET examination. This video is about anatomy of flowering plant part 2. If you have not seen my video anatomy of flowering plant part 1, I have given the link in the description box. Please visit. In this video, we are going to explain about permanent tissues. Start our discussion with plant tissues. Tissues are the group of cells common in origin, similar in structure and performing similar kind of functions. Depending on the dividing capacity of the cell, plant tissues can be divided into two types, meristematic tissues and permanent tissues. Meristematic tissues are those tissues which are in continuous state of division. This tissue contains meristematic cells. These cells have abundant cytoplasm, big nucleus and very thin cell wall. So it is easy for the cell to divide. Whereas the permanent tissues derive from the meristematic tissue, but it has lost its capacity of division either temporarily or permanently. So it is not dividing anymore. Permanent tissue can be further classified into simple permanent tissues and complex permanent tissues. Similar kind of cells make up the simple permanent tissues. So it can be described as homogeneous. They are of three types: parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. Complex permanent tissues are made up of different kind of cells and they are also of two types, that is xylem and phloem. We'll discuss about the simple permanent tissue in this video. So first we'll start our discussion with parenchyma. Let us see where the parenchyma is present in a plant body. If we take roots, stem, leaf, fruit, flowers, seeds, any soft tissue is made up of parenchymatous tissues. So it is also called as the filler tissues. Here we have taken one stem. So we have taken a stem and if we take the TS or transverse section of the stem, we can see that cortex and the pith region of the stem is made up of parenchymatous cells. Now, this fruit and the seed, the pulp part of the fruit and inside the seed also parenchymatous cells are present. Let us look at the parenchymatous cell which is present in the leaf. If we take this cross section of a leaf, we can find this is the upper epidermis and this is the lower epidermis. The parenchymatous cell which is present in between the upper and lower epidermis is called as the mesophyll cells. Mesophyll cells are consist of two kind of parenchyma. One is called as palisade parenchyma and another one is called as spongy parenchyma. Palisade parenchyma, which is present just below the upper epidermis and compactly arranged, have less space in between. Whereas the lower one, which is just above the lower epidermis, that's called as spongy parenchyma, are loosely arranged with lots of intercellular space which can communicate to outside through the stomata. Parenchymatous tissues are made up of parenchymatous cell. If we look at the cell under microscope, we find either they are spherical or they are oval or they are polyhedral. So their shape of the cell is directly proportional to its position. If we look at the leaf cells, it was looking elongated, but in the stem it was looking round. So the result of the pressure exerted upon it by neighboring cells and the internal torque created during the development. If we look at the cell in detail, we can find that there is dense protoplasm, a marginally placed nucleus and a big vacuole is there. This vacuole is very, very important because parenchymatous cell mostly storage in function. They do storage. If we look at the cell wall, it consists of two layers. One is called as the primary wall and other one is called as the secondary wall. But the cell wall is made up of either cellulose or hemicellulose. But we saw in the meristematic cells, cell wall is consist of only primary wall. The arrangement of the cells, if we look at this, we find there are lots of spaces in between, which is called as the intercellular space. So the cells are loosely arranged. What do this parenchyma do inside the plant? It is, if we initially we described it, it as a filler tissue. But the most important function is done by parenchyma. It is physiologically active in synthesis, storage and transport of metabolic products. It is the most important tissue for storage. So it is referred as simple living storage tissue. It stores carbohydrate, proteins and fats. Apart from that, in xerophytes, succulent xerophyte, parenchyma also contains mucilage, which helps in storing the water. If we break little bit, so we see that water is dripping out. It is stored in parenchymatous cells. Even the parenchymatous cell can store tannin, oil and calcium oxalate. The parenchyma which stores this tannin oils and calcium oxalate are called as the ideoblast. It's an important term to remember. Even in parenchyma, some parenchyma contains chlorophyll molecule and it is called as chlorenchyma. So chlorenchyma consists of two words, chlorophyll plus parenchyma. So this kind of parenchyma are important for synthesis of food. Parenchyma sometimes contains large air cavities. Look at this picture. If we can see that this parenchyma are loosely arranged here, it encloses some air space. So air gets filled in these cavities and helps the plant to float in the water. So most hydrophytes will see this kind of air cavities. So it gives buoyancy to the plant. This is mainly found in hydra, lily, lotus, which are aquatic plants, which lives in water. Another most important property of parenchyma tissue is that it can regain its power of division. It can, when there is a wound or there is some portion, some part of the plant is lost, it can fill that tissue, that particular parenchyma tissue gets its meristematic activity and it gets its power of redivision. And that is called as the dedifferentiation. Very, very important term to remember. The second type of simple permanent tissue is cholenchyma. So first let us look at its location, where it is present in the plant. Cholenchyma is present in the young stem or in the shoot system of the plant. It is also found in the expanding leaves in the herbaceous stem. And at the tip of the petiole, at the midrib of the petiole, this is the petiole where the leaf gets attached to the stem. This portion contains cholenchymatous cells. Even it is present in the midrib of the leaf. This is also present in the attachment site of fruits and flowers. So when the wind blows, that flower and fruits don't get detached from the plant. Fruits get detached only when it is mature. Cholenchyma is absent in roots. It's very important. Cholenchyma is present only in the shoot system.
So if we look at the position in the stem where it is present, it is just present below epidermis. This is called the epidermal layer, and below epidermis this portion is called as the hypodermis. So colenchyma is positioned just below epidermis, and either it is present in a continuous strand or it is present in the patches. The cells which makes colenchyma tissue is called as colenchymata cells. If we look at these cells in details, we find the cells are living because it contains lots of protoplasm and nucleus. It even contains sometimes chloroplast. We can see there is a big vacuole which is present inside the colenchyma. But if we look at its wall, there is primary wall and secondary wall. But the primary wall is made up of cellulose, hemicellulose and pectin material. So here we will find pectin, which is a heteropolysaccharide which is deposited on the primary wall of the colenchymata cell. These cells are derived from the parenchymata cells. So initially there is intercellular space, but due to deposition of the pectin, the intercellular space is lost. So in the mature colenchymata cells, sometimes we don't find any intercellular space. So based on the manner of the deposition of this pectin, we find there are four kind of colenchyma: angular colenchyma, lamellar colenchyma, annular colenchyma and lacunate colenchyma. Let us discuss about this colenchyma in details. So first we'll take up the angular colenchyma. So here we find that pectin is deposited only in the corner of the cell. This kind of colenchyma we see in the herbaceous stem and petiole. Second type of colenchyma is the lamellar colenchyma. We'll see this in the tangential wall only. A pectin deposition is there. So it looks like a lamella. Third type of colenchyma is the annular colenchyma, where we find that deposition of pectin is uniform in all the cells. This is the most common type of colenchyma. And the third, there's a fourth variety of the colenchyma is the lacunate colenchyma, which is somehow similar to the angular colenchyma. Here we find the pectin deposition is in the intercellular space. It's towards the intercellular space. The most important type of simple permanent tissue is colenchyma tissues. This is also called as living mechanical tissues. They give supporting function in growing stem and petiole of the leaves. When we saw its location, we found colenchyma is present in the hypodermal layer of stems and the tip of petiole in the attachment site of fruits and flowers. So it helps, it supports it to grow, as well as it protects it so it should not fall down. It provides mechanical strength to the different part of the plant. If we see there is hard wind blowing, we see that plant will bend, but it will not break due to the presence of colenchyma. Sometimes even colenchyma contains chloroplast. So those kind of colenchyma can assimilate food. Colenchyma is a living tissue, so it can store food material also. This is all about the function of colenchyma. Now we'll look at another important tissue, which is called as sclerenchyma. This is a sclerenchyma cells are present all over the plant. If we look at the roots, stems, leaves, fruit and seeds, everywhere sclerenchyma tissue is present. Let us look at the sclerenchyma cell structure. Sclerenchyma cells have thick wall. It consists of two layers of walls. One is called as primary wall, which is made up of cellulose, and the secondary wall is made up of lignin. This lignin because of the presence of lignin, there is no exchange of gas and water. So that in maturity, we find the cell is dead. The protoplasm is dead. And the vacuole is represented by lumen. There are two kinds of sclerenchyma cells. One is called as sclerenchyma fibers. Other one is called as the sclerids. Let us look at sclerenchyma. Let us look at the sclerenchyma fiber first. Sclerenchyma fibers are highly elongated, thick walled, and they are tapered at the ends, or they have a tapering end. Mostly these fibers occur in group. We can see that this is a fiber cell and this is a fiber cell. This is a fiber cell. They mostly occur in the groups. Fibers can occur inside the xylem or outside the xylem. Depending on that, they are of two types, intraxillary and extraxillary. Intraxillary are also called as the wood fiber and found inside the xylem. Extraxillary are either they are present in phloem or pericycle or cortex. They are mostly long and they have a blunt end. Here we have taken TS of fiber. We can see from the top it looks like this. Second type of sclerenchyma is called as sclerids. Sclerids are completely different from sclerenchyma fiber, which are very short, broad and spherical or oval or cylindrical, and they are highly thickened dead cell. We find that there is lots of lignin deposition on their wall, so the lumen is also highly reduced. They can either occur singly or they can occur in groups. We find various shapes of the sclerids. According to the shapes, it can be divided into brachysclerids, macrosclerids, osteosclerids, asteriosclerids, and trichosclerids. So first we'll look at the brachysclerids. Brachysclerids are also called as the stone cells. We can see here there is lots of deposition of lignins. Because of this, lumen is completely reduced. If we look at the pears or guava or sapota, the inside part is made up of this stone cells. The gritty structure is due to these stone cells or brachysclerids. Second type of sclerids, which is elongated in shape, mostly cylindrical, and it is called as macrosclerid. This is found in the seed coat of bean, in the epidermal layer of leguminosity seeds. Third type of sclerids is our asteriosclerids. It looks star-shaped, that is why the name is given asteriosclerids. It is found mostly in the leaf of the tea. Another type of sclerids is osteosclerids, which looks like a bone. It looks like a long bone, that's why the name is given like this. And this is mostly found in the seed coat of pea. It is found in the hypodermal region of the leguminosity plant. And another last type of sclerid is your trichosclerids, which is very thin needle-like structure, and it is found in the leaves of olive and the root of monotropa. So this is all about the type of sclerids we found depending on their shape. Sclerenchyma is best described as simple dead mechanical tissue. It is like collenchyma tissue, gives support and protection to the plant body. But the difference between collenchyma and sclerenchyma is that collenchyma is a living tissue, whereas the sclerenchyma is a dead tissue. And sclerenchyma's fiber has great commercial value, like jute and coir, which is the example of most commonly used commercial fibers. And the commercial fibers are of two types, soft fibers and hard fibers. Soft fibers are obtained from the phloem, which is also called as the bast fiber. Example is jute.
Hard fibers are obtained from the monocotyledons, and example is yucca and agave. Sclerites also present in the seed coat, and it provides the hard structure to the seed. In this video, we described about simple permanent tissue, that is parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. We described about the location, their structure and function. Next video will take up complex permanent tissue, that is xylem and phloem. If you like the video, please press the like button, subscribe and don't forget to press the bell. You can write your comments in the comment box, or any query, I'll answer it. Thank you. Bas. Bas.